No, bro, I gotta reflect. I gotta reflect. I can't be too hard on myself. I know where I come from the streets. I was living a completely different lifestyle before I came to the Deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I have to reflect on that, because if I don't, sometimes I can put unnecessary pressure on myself. I know as a Muslim I'm not doing enough. I know my sins, I know the mistakes that I make, But if I flash back to the life that I was living before, I can't even recognize the person I've become today. I never could imagine I'd be doing these type of things, Whereas before we were doing maybe certain things to harm people, now we're doing things to help people. Whether it was the way we were making money or things that we were encountering on the streets and whatnot, to be doing the things that we're doing now, it's amazing. And obviously, I'm not saying this in a way to praise myself, because wallahi, bro, I could be doing all this and I meet Allah Ta'ala, Allah don't accept none of it. So it's when you're doing good actions or you're working for the sake of Allah, you should never be too confident. Doesn't mean that you should be like, you know what, don't have hope in Allah, because I always have got hope in Allah, but don't be like, rah, I've got this in the bag. Yes, when I meet Allah, I'm guaranteed. There's no guarantee, bro. There's no guarantee. You know what I mean? There's no guarantee. So, but in regards to your main question, yeah, of course I reflect. Sometimes I. Well, like the other day, I was just driving down Wharf Road, and I was just looking at the area, and I was just like, SubhanAllah, this was my strip, this was my area. And it's like I was driving, and I was zoned out, bro. Like I was like I was having a dream. Like, SubhanAllah, the stuff that I used to do, like the stuff that we used to be doing around these areas, and now I'm doing this is crazy. That's why I love the statement, "You plan, but Allah Ta'ala is the best of planners," because if you would have told me 20 years ago that I'll be doing this, bro, I would have laughed my head off. Even, bro, I can even remember when people used to tell me about Islam. I was just like, this is mad, bro. You think I'm gonna give up all my life to start worshiping God and all that? You crazy. Like, I just used to think people who think like this are mad, And now I'm trying my best to worship the creator of the heavens and the earth, and trying to do good deeds and worrying about my bad deeds and stuff like that. Whereas my life before, I was concerned about dunya, making money. Girls, jewelry, cars, all this crap, raving, enjoying my life. And now I'm living the complete opposite, in Africa, helping poor people, sitting with poor people, breaking bread, cracking jokes, drinking tea with poor people, things that I never would have thought I would have been doing back in the day. So, alhamdulillah, we thank Allah, that we get the opportunity to do these type of things. And alhamdulillah, I'm happy that Allah has given me the opportunity to help people, because, bro, one thing I always tell people, there's nothing like helping somebody who can't do anything for you, because you feel like I'm doing it for the right cause. Like, what can this person do for me? Can't do anything for me. There's nothing, there's no payback. There's no payback. Like, obviously, yes, someone, you might help someone today and then maybe they come back 20 years, they might become something. But when you're looking at the situation at hand and you're helping someone for the sake of Allah, and you believe, like, there's nothing this individual can do for me. It's really nice, to do things to help our fellow human beings and people who need help. So definitely, bro, I reflect, man. It's not easy phase. Like, some of the thoughts that go through my mind to this day, bro, it's not normal. It's not normal. Like, wallahi, like, I chat to Musa, chat to MB, I chat to Lord, bro. Like, some of the things that go through my mind, even I have to say, everybody be like, what's this? What's this? It's crazy. But every day we're working to, purify myself and try to improve myself as a Muslim and try to improve myself as a human being, bro. That's important as well. Very important, because like I said, the lifestyle we were living before was horrid, bro. Horrid. It was nasty. Like, when you reflect about some of the things that you used to do, even sometimes I think to myself, how did I used to do that? Like, and had no shame. When you do things and you're just like, bro, even now I see some people do things, they're like, how did they do that? How, like, this person crazy, like, didn't have no shame. Sometimes I have to look at the things I used to do and I think, I did this and I didn't have a care in the world. Like, subhanAllah. So, alhamdulillah, man. Always alhamdulillah for Islam, alhamdulillah, trust me.